ಓಕೆ. ಸೊ ಯೆಸ್ಟರ್ಡೇ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ರಿಟನ್ ಎ ರಿಲೇಷನ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ಲೀನಿಯರ್ ವೆಲಾಸಿಟಿ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಗ್ಯುಲರ್ ವೆಲಾಸಿಟಿ. ನಮ್ಮ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ರಿಲೇಷನ್? ವಿ ಈಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ಸ್ ಟು ಒಮೇಗಾ ಇಂಟು ಆರ್. ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್? ಇನ್ ವೆಕ್ಟರ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಹೌ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ರಿಟನ್? ವಿ ಡ್ಯಾಶ್ ಈಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ಸ್ ಟು ಒಮೇಗಾ ಡ್ಯಾಶ್ ಕ್ರಾಸ್ ಆರ್ ಡ್ಯಾಶ್. ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್? ಸೊ ನೌ ವಿ ರೈಟ್ ಎ ರಿಲೇಷನ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ linear acceleration and angular acceleration. Linear acceleration and angular acceleration. Okay. So, just we will differentiate this relation, then we will get the required relation. So V is equals to omega into R, no? Just differentiate this one with respect to time. Then dV by dt is equals to d by dt of omega into R. dV by dt is nothing but acceleration, no? So acceleration is equals to, radius is a constant, d omega divided by dt. So A is equals to R alpha. This is the relation. Clear, ma? So from this relation only I got this relation. So what is A here? Linear acceleration. Alpha is called as angular acceleration. Clear? So this relation I can write like this also. A is equals to alpha into R. Or in vector form, how can I write down? Alpha dash is equal, A dash is equals to alpha dash cross R dash. This is how I can write the relation. Clear? Make a note of this. So if I have differentiated this relation, this is the equation which I got, Noma. A dash is equals to alpha dash cross R dash. Clear? So this is how I can indicate their directions here. So this is a circular path in which body is traveling. Then this is the direction of velocity, and same will be the direction of linear acceleration also. This is what kind of acceleration? Linear acceleration. Clear? Now, if this is the direction of linear velocity and linear acceleration, then what will be the direction of angular acceleration? So yesterday we have discussed, no, what is the rule for finding the directions of these angular quantities? Right hand rule. Right hand thumb rule also we can say. Clear? So you rotate the fingers of your right hand in the direction of motion of the body, then thumb will give the direction of these angular vectors. Alpha, omega and theta. Clear, ma? So also you can find out by using this relation also, right hand rule for cross product, alpha dash cross R dash. Clear, ma? So alpha is in this direction, no? So place your right hand on first vector. So radius is in this direction, radius is in this direction here. So alpha dash cross R dash. Then what is the direction of thumb here? Thumb is in this direction. In this direction it means that it is perpendicular to the board. from the center only. Alpha dash cross R dash. Clear, ma? So this is the direction of velocity and this is the direction of linear acceleration also. Clear? So they are perpendicular and inside the board. Okay? Or if you consider this as the radius, then you can do like this also. So this is also alpha. Radius is in this direction, no? So alpha dash cross R dash, then this is the direction of velocity and acceleration. Are you able to understand, ma? So this is how we find out their directions. Okay, make a note. Some conditions in which centripetal force is applied. Okay. So, see, ma'am. For example, on a table, on a horizontal table, we are tying a thread at the center and we are rotating this thread. Clear? So here, who is providing the centripetal force? Tension provides the centripetal force. Clear? So here I can write down, if linear velocity of the body is V, mass of this body is M. Clear? Then I can write down, tension is equals to MV square divided by R, where R is the radius of the circular path. Clear? Okay. Now in the same table, what I have done is, I have cut some part of the table and I have removed some layers from that one. Clear, ma? Some part of the table is cut here. Clear? And I have removed some part of the table. Now here a vertical groove is formed. Are you able to understand? Some part of the table, if I cut and remove, a small gap will be created now. So in that gap, a ball is moving now. Clear? If I place this ball and if I give velocity to this ball, then ball will move in this groove, no? The smaller depth which is formed there. Clear? So here, who is providing the centripetal force, can you say? There is no string there. Normal reaction given by whom? No. Are you able to understand what we are saying here? Huh? So here, two normal reactions are there. Clear, ma? One is normal reaction given by the table. Another one is normal reaction given by the groove which is formed there. So who is providing the normal reaction here? Normal reaction provided is by the groove in this condition. This one. So some part of the table, if I cut and remove, a small depth will be created, no? So that depth will behave like a groove in this condition. Clear, ma? So if I take a free body diagram of this ball, so this is weight mg of the ball. Clear? Weight is acting downwards. And the table is giving some normal reaction, no? That is acting upwards. Then for this ball to rotate in this circle, are you able to understand? Some centripetal force must be acting. Who is giving this centripetal force? Groove is present here, no? So this groove gives the required centripetal force, clear? Which is also called as normal reaction N2. So here I can write N2 is equals to MV square divided by R. So normal reaction by the groove is providing the centripetal force in this condition. Okay, ma? Okay. Similarly, if I take a table which is rotating, which can rotate on this axis, and it is rotating like this with an angular velocity of omega. Clear, ma? So on this table, if I place a block here, okay, then block also rotates along with the table, no? This block also rotates along this table. So here, who is providing the centripetal force? For any body to move in circular path, definitely centripetal force is required, ma? That is what we discussed yesterday. So here, who is providing the centripetal force? That is the question. No, weight and normal reaction are acting downwards. If you take this block, weight is acting downwards, no? Normal reaction is acting upwards.
Friction is there, friction.
Friction provides the centripetal force in this condition.
Sir, but in this condition you said there is no friction.
I never said there is no friction, no? That's what I said. If it is moving along with the table, it definitely means that there is a friction between table and the block. Clear, ma? So in this condition, who is providing the centripetal force here? Friction provides the centripetal force. And here I can say F is equals to mv square divided by r, where m is mass of the body, velocity is the linear velocity of this body, and r is the radius from which this body is present. Are you able to understand? Okay. Now my condition is, for example, at this position, at a distance of r, are you able to understand? Let this friction be mu Sn. What is meant by mu Sn? Limiting friction. Limiting friction. Are you able to understand, ma? So at this position, at a distance of r, how much friction is applied by the table here?
Mu Sn.
Mu Sn. That is limiting friction is applied here in this condition. Okay. Now, instead of placing this block, I have placed this block at a greater distance here. Are you able to understand? I have placed this block at a greater distance. Okay. Now, can this block rotate along this table or not? That is the question. FL is a constant. FL already it has reached a limiting friction, no? Okay? Try to think about and say, first you make a note of all this. Come on. So have you understood, ma? Here a tension is providing centripetal force. Normal reaction by the groove is providing centripetal force. Here friction is providing the centripetal force. Now, have you understood the question which I have asked you? Clear? See. So this is the turning table. Clear? So previously when I have placed the block here at a distance of some r. Understand? Then the friction which reached here is limiting friction is equals to mu Sn and it is providing the centripetal force mv square by r. Clear? So how much friction is developed between block and this table? Limiting friction. It means friction has already reached the maximum position. Now friction cannot go beyond this value. Clear? Now what I am doing is, I am taking this box from here and placing at a greater distance, r. Now will this block, can it rotate along with the table or will it slip down? That is my question. How can you say?
Limiting friction will reduce.
Limiting friction is a constant, no? Friction depends on what? Friction depends on normal reaction and coefficient of friction. These two are constant. Mu S is a constant. Normal reaction mg. Weight of the body is also constant. Clear? Then what happens if I take this block from here to here? What are the changes which are going to happen?
Sir, the centripetal acceleration will reduce.
Sima, if I place this block from here to here, radius is increasing, no? Distance of this body from the center is increasing. Clear? Then what happens to the velocity of this body? What happens to linear velocity? Linear velocity also must increase. Do you remember why? Because V is equals to omega into R, no ma? V is equals to omega into r. If this table is rotating with the same angular velocity, then I can say v is directly proportional to radius, no? Angular velocity of the table is constant. With what velocity it is covering the angle, that is a constant. So table's linear velocity and angular velocity are same. Understand? So therefore I can say linear velocity is directly proportional to radius. That's all, no? So, if I place this block nearer, then radius will be small. No? Then its linear velocity of the block will be smaller. Understand? Same block if I place here, then what will happen? Radius increases, no? So, therefore, its linear velocity also must increase. Are you able to understand? So, therefore, in this relation, if I can write centripetal force is equals to mv square by r. Then V can be written as omega into R, no? So therefore, if I substitute, so M by R into, instead of V, I can write omega square into R. So FC is equals to MR omega square. This is another formula for centripetal force. That's all, Noma? FC is equals to MR omega square. Have you seen this relation previously? One relation is mv square by r. And v is equals to omega into r, no? So if I substituted, this is one more relation for centripetal force. So why we are writing this relation here? Because centripetal force depends on mass of the body, no? And here mass is a constant. Same body, no? Just I am displacing from here to here. Mass is a constant. Angular velocity of the table is constant. Table is rotating with same angular velocity, it is not changing. Then what about radius? Radius now it is increasing. No, radius means previously this was distance r1. Now this is distance r2. Distance has increased, no? So centripetal force also must increase. Who is providing centripetal force here? Friction. And friction value already it has reached maximum value when body was present here, no? Now when you place here, friction must increase, which is not possible. Therefore, this body will definitely slip on the table. Are you able to understand, ma? If I place body at a greater distance, then friction should increase to compensate the increase in centripetal force. But friction has already reached the maximum value when body was present here. Understand? So if you increase the distance, friction cannot increase, no? So centripetal force also cannot increase. So the body will slip here. Are you able to understand, ma? So this is the relation. Or we can understand like this also. Clear, ma? So if this is the turning table, horizontal turning table, then what about this point and this point? This point will be rotating in this smaller circle, no? Are you able to understand? This point will be rotating in a bigger circle. Are you able to understand? Then for these two points, there is one common parameter, and for these two points, there is one different parameter also. Can you say what is that?
Radius.
Radius is okay. Next. What is the common character between these two points, point P1 and point P2? Can you see? So theta, angular velocity, angular acceleration, linear velocity, linear acceleration. Out of all these, for these two points, which is the common parameter? So this table is rotating like this. Clear? Then what is the common thing between these two? And what is the different point between these two? Linear velocity is? No. See, ma. After a time of 1 second, these two points, for example, we considered, they have reached here. They will reach here, no? Again, in the same straight line, they will reach. Clear, ma? So one thing which I can say is, both of them have covered same angle, no? Both of them have covered same angle or not? Clear? So theta is common for both of them. So if theta is common and time is common, then angular velocity is also common. They are covering same angle in same time. So for these two, the common thing is that angular velocity is same. That's all, Noma? Angular velocity is same. But what about linear velocity? Linear velocity means this velocity. This is V1, this velocity is V2. So linear velocity depends on which factors? Omega into R. So as radius increases, its linear velocity also increases. That's all, Dhamma. Because linear velocity is directly proportional to radius. So out of these two, point 1 and point 2, whose radius is greater? P2 radius is greater, no? Therefore, its linear velocity must be greater. That's all, no? So therefore I can write V2 is greater than V1. So linear if it is not accelerating, okay, consider if it is traveling with uniform motion, uniform circular motion. Clear? So linear velocity of V2 should be greater than linear velocity of V1. And just now we have derived that centripetal force, another relation is mr omega square. That's all, no? It means if body is at a greater distance, then it requires more centripetal force to travel in a circular path. That's all, no? Mass is a constant. Angular velocity is a constant for same bodies which are present on this table. Understand? For this point and this point, which is the common thing? Omega is common, no? Understand? But for this point and this point, what is the different parameter? Radius is different. Understand? And whose radius is greater here? Point P2's radius is greater. So therefore, for body which is present at point 2, it requires more centripetal force to travel in a circular path. Are you able to understand? So velocity of this point will be greater, and this point requires more centripetal force. Clear? So make a note about this point. Write down. For a table, for a table rotating horizontally, if we take points P1 and P2, which are at distances of R1 and R2 from the center of the circle, then these two points will cover same angle in same time. Therefore, their angular displacement and angular velocity is same. Okay? But linear velocity depends on omega and r. As omega is same, v is directly proportional to R. Okay, ma? For these two points, angular velocity is same, no? So linear velocity of these points will depend on radius. So therefore, I can say V1 should be less than V2 as R1 is less than R2. Okay? So linear velocity of point present at P1 is less than linear velocity of the point present at P2. Okay? So therefore, centripetal force is equals to mr omega square. Centripetal force, we know it is equal to mr omega square. Here, mass and omega are constant. Therefore, centripetal force is directly proportional to radius. Therefore, FC2 is greater than FC1. Clear, ma? What is FC2? Centripetal force of 0.2. And P1 is centripetal force of 0.1. Clear, ma? So, this is the conclusion we have drawn finally. Okay? So therefore, if I place any particle at P2, it requires more centripetal force than the point which is placed at P1. Clear? Okay. So, now I will give you some problems. Try to solve it. See. So here, a ball of mass m is rolling down, clear? And radius of this circular path is, let radius is equals to 2 meters, mass of the body is 10 kg, and when this body has reached here, its velocity was 2 meters per second, clear? Then find out the normal reaction in this condition. That is the question. Come on. Ela chestaru cheyandi. Similarly, you do one more problem. Okay. Calculate chesinara. So, body is again traveling in this type of path. Mass is same mass. What is the mass? 10 kg. It was moving in this direction with a velocity of 2 meters per second. Again, radius of this circular path is 2 meters. In this condition, what is the normal reaction? Clear? So, if body was present here, okay, let us draw the free body diagram of this one. Normal reaction by the ground will be upwards, and weight of this body is acting downwards, no? This parameter you forgot here. Clear? So when it is moving in this type of path, then it is traveling in this circular path, no, here? Then centripetal force should be towards the center or away from the center? Centripetal force direction is always towards the center of the circle, no? It means that normal reaction must be greater than mg here, then only net force will be towards the center. Are you able to understand? So therefore I can write n must be greater than mg, then only net force will be in this direction. Clear, Noma? And n minus mg provides the centripetal force, which is equals to mv square divided by r. So therefore normal reaction is equals to mg plus mv square divided by r. So what is the mass of this body? 10. So 10 into 10 plus m into, again mass is 10. Velocity is how much? 2. So 2 square divided by radius? 2. So therefore how much total? 100 plus 10 into 2. So therefore 120 newton will be the normal reaction in this condition. Are you able to understand? Try this one. Try this question. Solve the problem. So if I take the free body diagram, normal reaction is acting upwards, no? Weight of the body is acting downwards. So definitely mg must be greater than n here. Why mg must be greater than n here? Then only net force will be acting downwards, no? And that force will be responsible for centripetal force. Are you able to understand? Because centripetal force is always towards the center of the circle. Clear, Noma? So therefore, what can I write? Mg minus n should provide mv square by r. Clear? So therefore, normal reaction will be how much? Mg minus mv square by r. So again, same condition. Mass is how much? 100 minus. This value is how much? 20. So 80 newton is my answer. Are you able to understand? That's all. So here, can you say what is meant by here 120 newton and what is the meaning of 80 newton there? Here, this surface is experiencing more force here. Are you able to understand, ma? This surface is experiencing more force when compared to actual weight of the body. What is the actual weight of the body? Only mg. 10 into 10, 100 newtons is the weight of the body. But this ground is experiencing more force when compared to 100 Newton. And what is the force it is experiencing? 120 Newton. And what force it will experience, same force it will give as normal reaction, no? According to Newton's third law. Understand? So in this condition, what I can say, apparent weight is greater than actual weight of the body when it is in rest position. This is the resultant finally which I can understand. Are you able to understand, ma? What is meant by apparent weight? The weight which is felt by the ground. This ground is some feeling some weight of this body, no? That weight here I call it as apparent weight. Or you can call it as just a normal reaction also. Or you can say that weight of the body when it is in motion. Weight of the body when it is in motion. So this weight is greater than actual weight of the body when body is in rest position. Understand? Actual weight of the body is only 100 Newton. But how much normal reaction the ground is giving? Ground is giving a normal reaction of 120 Newton. In which condition ground will give more normal reaction? When more force is acting on the ground. That's all, no? If you push a body with greater force, the body also will give an equal and opposite force. Clear? What about the condition here? Actual weight of the body is how much? Actual weight of the body is only 100 Newton. But normal reaction is how much? 80. Only 80 Newton. What is the meaning of this one? Total weight of the body is not falling on the ground. Only some of the weight is falling. And so here what can I write? Here I can write apparent weight is less than actual weight of the body. That's all, Amma. Actual weight means when body is in rest position. Have you understood both the situations? Oh, write down, Ma. Turning of a car due to friction. Turning of a car due to friction or rotating in a circular path only because of friction on a horizontal road. Clear, ma'am? No. Banking of angle we are not studying. Okay. See, ma'am. So here, this is a car. How to draw a car? Consider this is a car. Clear? So this should travel in this circular path like this. Understand, ma'am? Then to move in this circular path of radius r, which force is required? Centripetal force is required. Who provides this centripetal force? Only friction provides the centripetal force in this condition. Clear, ma? Road is horizontal. It does not have any banking. Clear, ma? So for a body to move in a horizontal path, there must be some force which is pulling this body towards the center, no? And here that force must be frictional force because there is no other force. Clear? So therefore here I can write friction provides the centripetal force. Understand? So in the same path, if I want to travel with a greater velocity, then friction must be greater, no? If velocity should be maximum, friction also must be maximum. And what is the maximum friction possible? A maximum friction possible is limiting friction. Understand? So therefore, for this limiting friction, the maximum velocity possible is V max square divided by R. That's all, Dhamma. So for this road and for this limiting friction, I can travel with this velocity. So if I travel with a velocity greater than this velocity, then what will happen? I cannot move in a circular path. I will move in a straight line. Are you able to understand? To move in a circular path, what force is required? Centripetal force, and here centripetal force is provided by friction. And friction cannot have unlimited values, no? It can have only up to a maximum value of limiting friction. So therefore, there will be a limit for maximum velocity also. Understand? So, and what is the formula for limiting friction? mu s n is equals to mv max square divided by r. That's all, no? And n, how can I write? Mg is equals to n v max square divided by r. Mass, mass, if I get cancel, then what is the velocity which I am getting? Yes. So therefore, v max is equals to square root of mu s gr. This is my relation. Are you able to understand? Clear, ma? So this is the maximum velocity which I can move in that circle, whose coefficient of friction is mu s and whose radius is r. Are you able to understand? One point which we can understand is v max is independent of m. Here also I got the same relation, no? V max is independent of mass of the body which is traveling in the circular path. Clear? So in if it is not independent of m, then what should happen? For different roads, for same road, different vehicles should have different maximum velocity. Correct? If you are traveling on a road, he will be writing a limit board, no? In this road, you have to travel with a maximum limit of 40 km per hour. Understand? This is the limit for which body? For cycle, car, scooter, for which body? For lorry. When you are taking in a turning, there will be one signboard, no? He will be writing limit is 40 km per hour. So that limit is for which body, I am asking you? Is it for cycle, scooter? This limit is for everybody, because that's what here we are writing, no? V max is independent of mass of the body. For car also, same velocity. For lorry also, same velocity. For bike also, that is the maximum velocity with which you can travel on that road. Are you able to understand, ma? So V max is independent of mass of the body. For any body, maximum velocity with which we can travel in a horizontal road is same. Are you able to understand? Okay. So now keep the side heading. Turning of a car due to banking of roads. Due to banking of roads. Okay. Doubt, eh? Mira. So now we have studied turning of a car due to friction, no? Now we are studying due to banking of roads. Clear? See here. So at the turning, you should have seen that road will be raised upwards by a small angle theta, no? Have you seen this? When you are taking a turning, their road will not be horizontal generally. Road will be raised by a small angle theta. And what is the purpose of raising this road by a small angle theta? Because this raising also provides centripetal force. For a body to move in a circular path, definitely centripetal force is required, no? So let us see how this banking is responsible for providing the centripetal force. Clear? So this is a body, this is a car you consider. How to draw a car? Beautiful car. Clear? So it is traveling in a circular path. Then how many forces are acting on this one? One force is mg, which is acting downwards, no? And normal reaction will be acting in this direction. Clear? Clear, ma? So this normal reaction, can I split into two components? I can split like this, no? If this is theta, then this angle also will be theta only. Then this is n cos theta, this is n sin theta. Understand? So definitely I can say n cos theta is equals to mg. They are in the same straight line, no? So n cos theta and mg must be balancing with each other. Understand? Then is there any force to balance this n sin theta? There is no other force, no? It means that this n sin theta is providing the centripetal force. That's all, no? So therefore I can say n sin theta provides the centripetal force and it is equals to mv square divided by r. So that is why we raise the rod by a small angle of theta. So to provide this n sine theta. Are you able to understand? So therefore, again, if I divide these two, what I will get? Tan theta is equals to mv square by r divided by mg. So mass and mass gets cancelled. So tan theta is equals to v square by gr. So theta is equals to tan inverse of v square by gr. Clear ma? So what is meant by this theta is equals to tan inverse of v square by gr? To travel with this velocity, the angle should be raised by this much. That is the meaning of this one. Clear ma? Theta is equals to tan inverse of v square by gr, which is called as banking angle. Okay? Make a note of that. So one more important point which you can write. So therefore I can say banking angle is independent of mass of body. Okay? So for different masses there cannot be different banking angles, no? Understand? For every body banking angle will be same. Okay? That's all. It's all ended.